For your clients who are a little bit more seasoned, and let's just say are coming over the hill with, you know, getting their debt eliminated, under control, whatever you want to call it.
Yeah.
What are those conversations like when you're with them now? Because obviously, I think you're doing more game planning for what's next for with that client.
Got it. All right, I'll take you through the process. So let's say someone just enrolls. I'm going to use Adrian, for example, because he's brand new, but has been following me for a year. So he kind of knows how I operate to an extent. So Adrian comes in the course, the material, gets to know me, right? We do one-to-one and he's watching the videos, right? He's learning. I talk to him. He gets to a point where you're mentioning of control. And he may already be in control of his money or may not, but we're not going to judge him just yet. I'm giving the benefit of the doubt. So let's say he gets to a point where he's like, yeah, you know, paid off a lot of debt, you know, debt is down, he's built his credit, both personal and business, let's say.
Mm-hmm.
He's saving. He's got that emergency fund. He's like, dude, I sleep well at night, or wife told me I need to have an emergency fund of 10K. So let's just say we have that. He's got debt tools, right? I would say a good 40, 60% of my clientele are right here. Mm-hmm. A good amount of people are right here at this point. And the next stage is typically IBC, right? After a year or 2 years, he's like, dude, I got to get into this. Okay. So they get a policy and he's like, you know, I like what you've been saying about crypto. So he might open up a crypto account. And he's like, look, I could move a portion of my savings into crypto and be earning like 10, 20% returns in this market right now. It's volatile, but I mean, this thing's going nowhere but up over the tracker of the last 10 years, 12 years. So let's say he does that. And then he opens up an HSA. Maybe he's got a Roth already. You know, just depends, right? Starts opening up different types of investment accounts for the long term. Mm-hmm. But then there's a component of clients that completely ignore all of this and maybe even majority of this, mm-hmm. right? Some, not all. And they're right here in the 10X camp, you know? Because I like to be transparent with people and I say, look, I personally, Denzel, I went this route first in 2018. I was doing velocity banking in 2017 and 2018. And then I stopped. Why? Because I got fired at my job. So I lost all my income at the time. And then I pivoted, started the YouTube channel, started selling different products and services and just sharing my message of the kingdom, and money just started coming in. And I took the model of 10X. Once I 10X, and not even, I didn't even have to 10X. I really like 4 or 5X. And I got to a point where I kind of went back here, paid off all my debt, and then started hiring people to teach me about credit and different alternative ways of saving money. That's where IBC came into the equation. And, different debt tools. That's where I met Sebastian. Credit, that's where I met Brittany Green. IBC, I was already connected to Steve Parisi in early 2018, but I had him on my radar this whole time. 10X included of networking first, collaboration, good old sales. I think this is, I mean, you're either selling something or you're being sold something in this economy. And there's a book called Sell or Be Sold by Grant Cardone. Highly recommend reading it. I also highly recommend reading the 10X rule. It'll blow your mind. You know, when people hear the word sales, it leaves a sour taste in a lot of people's mouths. But honestly, for me, it gets me so excited because sales leads, I say it's the end game, but networking leads to the sale, collaboration leads to sale, sharing the message, sharing your story, sharing a business idea, creating content, you know, all these different things, it leads to the sale. You just sold someone, you've persuaded them, you've convinced them, you've shared your ideas, and they now love you for it because you changed their life. So got a couple clients that are on this path, in order to be on this path, you, I think there's some interesting qualities you need to have. I think you definitely need to be willing to take a lot of risk. And when I say risk, that means stepping into your kingship, right? And for the women, queen, like you're becoming something that you were originally designed to be. And that is very risky. Why? Because with freedom comes great responsibility. With, you know, with accountability, I mean, you are taking individual responsibility over everything that happens in your life. That's the risk. And it's scary as hell. Right? It's scary as can be to take this pathway. Very, very scary. Why? Because the person on the other side, you will not know who that is. And that fear of success is what holds a lot of people back. It's not because they can't get there. It's not because they don't want to get there. I think people are genuinely scared of success. I'm scared of success. I mean, there's still things that I do personally that I mess up sometimes, either purposely or I'll do certain things that won't get me into a high level room, mm-hmm. even though I was invited, you know, or I'll be like, my God, if I step in that room, I'm going to come out a millionaire, like a multimillionaire. If I step in that room, I'm coming out a multimillionaire. So oftentimes I close those doors to continue to say, stay in my lane. Mm-hmm. Which has mm-hmm. it has its pros and cons. What I mean by that, for example, I love working with moms, mm-hmm. but I cannot tell you how many people fill out my form that are making $20,000, $15,000, $25,000 a month. To me, one to two people a month, that's a lot to me. One to mm-hmm. two people that are making over high five figures, I don't pay attention to them. But I get a mom $4,000 a month. Send her an email. How you doing? What's going on? How can I help you? What can you afford? Da da da. Okay, cool. Sign up for here. Start here. Do this. Do that. Da da da. Come back to me when you get to this result. I'm obviously going to make a lot less with that. Mom's going to take more time, but I'm in my lane. I'm in my purpose. But I know at any moment I can reach out to these people over here, start working with them, and I can produce some very, very high sales either through one-to-one consulting that I've got, my programs, working with them on life insurance policies. I can't tell you how many people are putting $50,000, $100,000, $200,000, $150,000 policies in place per year funding these things. This is big money when you're a 25-year-old kid. It's big money. Mm-hmm. So when you're on this 10X route, there's a lot of danger. There's a lot of fear. There's a lot of doubt. Uncertainty, but I can tell you, man, if you 10x once in your life, you go from making $5,000 to $50,000 a month, man, the benefits are insane. Just the amount of leverage that you have, the amount of accessibility, the amount of people that want to come to you now. When before nobody wanted to talk to you, now everybody so obviously want to talk to you. What happened? You know, you became. Mm-hmm. The king, the queen that you ought to be. And I'm not trying to tie money to kingship and queen, but there's a correlation. I've never met a poor king or a poor queen before. We look at all the scriptures in the Bible. I mean, there's people that rose to power and then fell. Yeah, we hear that all the time. But those that were in power were not poor by any means. They've had the wisdom, they had the wealth, the knowledge, and the authority to claim what's theirs. So networking, collaboration, sales, creating content, building a business, like actually, I'm not talking investing in stocks and crypto and real estate. I'm talking actual people that are starting up trucking companies, food and beverage service, small business. I've got some clients that are doing that, coaches, consultants, CPAs, doctors, nurses that are building a business that they have a skill in. Mm-hmm. And usually sales is I would agree. I would argue sales is the fastest way to step into that new skill that you want to do without having the responsibility of the business and the startup costs. You know, you could work with another business owner, another entrepreneur, and be like a number two, number three, number four, number five in their company, kind of learn all the ins and outs of what it's like to be a CEO and run a company and branch off. Now you've got the liquidity to do that. That's what I did, honestly. I continue to do that. So that's how 10X looks. Majority of my clients are right here, just managing the money and developing the mundane, right? The sound principles of money, saving, tithing, investing, taxes, debt, credit, cash flowing, increasing income at their job. You know, I encourage these people. I'm like, you know, I can't tell you how many moms I talked to that worked in the same hospital for 10, 15 years, the same state government for 10, 15 years, never asked for a raise. Mm-hmm. They just was given the raise to them. But I'm like, every 90 days, you need to have an evaluation. You need to have a progress report. You need to have good relationships with your managers and your bosses and the C-suite executives. You need to know these people, get to know them, email them. Hey, I'm in the company, I'm looking to grow. Hey, I'm in the company, I'm looking to grow. Get your 60, 90-day, 120-day evaluations or whatever. You get like two or three of them in the books throughout a 12-month calendar, and then negotiate a pay raise. Don't just settle for a 50-cent increase, a dollar or $2 increase. Negotiate that. There's money in the marketplace, especially today, right now. My God, my goodness, a ton of money in the market. There's a lot of people not going back to work. Now's the time to work. When you see everybody not working and sitting and being late, now's the time to ask for that managerial role, that regional, national role in the company. You'd be surprised. A lot of these big corporations have a lot of people working remote. You say, no, I'm willing to come in to the office. I'm willing to go to the meetings. Invite me to the Zoom meetings. I want to be a part of it. Hey, is there a C-suite of executive position open? Is there a national, regional managerial role position open? You could 2X your income just from doing that. So I like to encourage some of my clients to do that. That can speed up us getting out of debt 2 years faster, 3 years faster. And then we start to formulate, once we get past this point of control, like I may still be in debt, but like I fully understand velocity banking, fully understand how to pay off debt. I know my timeline. I know my numbers each and every month. Now I got it like clockwork. I'm not tempted by other things. If an emergency comes up, I've got a system. I've got 0% credit cards. Let's say, like I said, a good amount of people are there, right there. Once we start moving over to financial freedom lane, where you want to get to that next level, we have to, you know, map out the timeline. For majority of my clients that are between 40 and 55, I only have about a 7 to 10 year window with most of my clients, usually about a 7 to 10 year window. Most of the conversation is getting out of debt or taking control of the debt, building some kind of a savings asset, and then some type of investment strategy. And then very few cancel all that out. And they're like, nah, I want to build a business. I want to increase my income, not through passive investing, but through activity. And I've got 7 to 10 years to do it. You know, say they're 50. They're like, dude, by 60, I want to be done. I'm like, okay. Well, instead of paying off debt, now that you have control of that, we got rid of all the bad. All you got is the mortgage and student loans. Instead of taking 5 years to pay that off, how about we take the next 5 years and develop a strategy? I'll use an example of a truck driver. I got a lot of truck driver clients. Talk to these guys all the time and women. I'm like, look, you've been driving trucks making $6,000 a month or $8,000. I know truckers today, clients, bringing in 20, 15 plus thousand. Can we go from 6 to 15, 8 to 20 in the next 2 years? How do we do that? Well, one way, we could acquire business credit. We could build business credit, acquire 0% debt, and buy your truck. Okay, now that you own the truck, you're gonna learn the operations. You've been driving trucks for 15 years, 12 years, 10 years, but you've never owned the truck before. How about we own the truck? Or matter of fact, don't own it. Leverage it at a very, very low rate and have someone else drive the, the thing, right? And create a split, you know? Or you buy two trucks through debt, got two guys driving it. I mean, we can go all day with this. There's another strategy where I was talking to this one truck driver that was kind of right over here in this range, in between 20 and 18,000 a month. And I was telling him, I was like, dude, the clothes that you wear, the bottle that you, you know, store your water in, the boots that you wear, the seat covering, the dash cam, these are all tools that can improve the day of a truck driver by wearing certain clothes when it's in the heat or the cold weather, a certain bottle that carries water, certain boots that make your feet feel comfortable, certain seat cover, a proper dash cam in case you got any of these terrible drivers that cut in front of you and that messes with, you know, the potential of you getting a ticket. You know, you can talk about the CSA scores. You can talk about how to maintain, you know, A-list driver, and talk about how someone can get into the industry through creating content. Right? Gives you a little camera, right? Put your camera on the side of the steering wheel. You're driving trucks for 8 hours. What the heck are you doing in that thing for 8 hours, 10 hours a day? Listening to the radio, podcast, talking on the phone, communicating with other truck drivers. Every now and then when you stop, go for lunch, you can talk about how you eat healthy on the road. How do you eat healthy on the road? How do you do that? Imagine you create a video, a YouTube channel, Instagram, just talking about that. Very niche, but you gain the respect of your fellow truck drivers, especially the new ones coming into the industry. And like, dude, man, I want to drive truck, but I don't want to get fat, you know, because I got to eat all day long on the road and I want to be able to eat healthy. How can I pack proper lunches? How can I, you know, what is the best fridge that I can use? What type of clothes should I be wearing to feel comfortable, so I'm not like, you know, drenched in sweat all day, the type of boots. I mean, we can go all day. And all you have to do is create content, talk about your story as a truck driver, how you operate, how you, you know, how do you maintain a marriage when you're gone, you know, traveling cross country? How do you maintain a marriage? There's so many different angles you can go. And then what you do is the products that you already been purchasing and using for God knows how many years as a truck driver, look at the brands on the different things, look at the brands, look them up, and see if they have any affiliate or referral partnerships that you can sign up for. And you get a special link. It's at the bottom of your video, in the description, in the comment section. You put your link. Hey guys, I wear these boots, been wearing them for God knows how long. They're custom made. They're the best in the market. Go right here. Every time someone buys a pair of boots, you get $5. How many boots do truck drivers go through in a 5-10 year? Maybe five. So one person might buy 5 pairs of boots. I get $5 per boot sale, $25, times that by 100 truck drivers. That's an extra $2,500. Say you do that over 1 year, an extra $2,500 a year on automation, no work. Okay, multiply that by 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 other products that you roll in every day, the lunchbox that you store your food in. See who made that lunchbox. I've been prepping for years. You see these shirts that I wear? It's by a company called Buttercloth. I've been prepping for years. I'm gonna develop a relationship with them. They're gonna see that I wear nothing but Buttercloth on my YouTube channel. I got all these different shirts that I have them right here. All these different shirts. These are expensive shirts. They're not cheap. It makes me unique. I like the little, you know, the cuffs here. It's like a $90-$100 shirt. And they've got an affiliate referral thing. I know they have one. I signed up for it a while back and I never did anything with it. But when I find the time, I'm going to reach out to the owners, try to have a conversation with them, try to get them on my YouTube channel, talk about their product. And they're going to be like, I don't know why they would refuse me. They're gonna be like, damn, this guy's got freaking $400-$500 videos. He's just promoting it. God knows how much money I already lost from people that asked, hey, what's that shirt you're wearing? Oh, it's Buttercloth. Okay, cool. This watch right here is made by Invicta. But I have another one Movado. I like Movado. I'm gonna wear Movado watches and Invicta watches for God knows how many years on my YouTube channel. Eventually, I'm gonna establish a relationship with them. I'm gonna reach out, like, hey, I like your watches. You got any referral, affiliate type of relationship? Bomb, bomb, bomb. You see where I'm going with that? Any questions? You guys have any thoughts? Is this like sinking in? Little things, right? You build over time, but you gotta find which aligns with what you're already skilled in. So when I'm talking to the truck driver, I'm like, I don't know if we wanna be selling Invicta watches or shirt or like, you know, dressy shirts or suits, because you don't wear that when you're driving 8 to 10 hours. But if you sell things that you know truck drivers buy every week, every month, twice a year, three times a year, and struggles that men and women, truck drivers go through, marriages, divorces, money problems. You can even talk about velocity. I have one truck driver that worked with way back in like late 2018, early 2019. Is one of my earliest examples. He's making like $15,000 a month, I think. I believe now, haven't spoke to him in a while, but he did say, I'm going to teach fellow truck drivers velocity banking. I said, while you're at it, charge them. You know, once you learn and you get it down, either work out some arrangement, buy me lunch, buy me dinner, you know, some kind of reciprocation so that they appreciate what you're doing for them. So they don't just take the knowledge and do nothing with it, because then now you just wasted your time, and your time is money. So don't be casting your pearls to swine that aren't going to treat you with the wisdom and knowledge that you have. Charge a little bit, something, some skin in the game. And I have another guy way back when I was doing videos in my room. I had this small whiteboard. If you guys go back to my YouTube channel, I have a very, very small whiteboard. There was a guy, he became a client, reached out to him. He said, I'm going to do what you do. I want to teach what you do in my local neighborhood, in my local area. I'd like to buy you a bigger board, because he heard me say in a video that I wanted to upgrade to get a bigger board, and it cost $200 at the time. I couldn't afford it. I was just working with this $30, $40 easel whiteboard type of thing. He said, I'll trade you that whiteboard and I'll buy you the whiteboard that you want on Amazon. Have it delivered to your house. So I made a bunch of videos in advance. I wouldn't run out of content. And then I packaged up my whiteboard. I sent it to his address. And then within like a few days, I had this big old whiteboard, and that upped the value of my video, because I was able to illustrate bigger, longer examples. And at this point in time, I'm pretty sure people in his neighborhood know who he is. He was like, I'm going to be doing meetings in my house. This was pre-COVID, and I'm going to teach people this stuff. So velocity banking could be a very conversation starter when you're networking, collaborating with other people, life insurance. So you can have something that you don't necessarily make money in, but it's the opener to your other product that you want to present. And that's typically how I like to do it when I'm networking in person with people. I never sell velocity banking, life insurance. I just say, yeah, I got this YouTube channel, been building it for a couple of years. You know, I downplay it. You know, I remain humble, full humility, transparency. I'm like, yeah, you know, I'm doing this. If you want to learn how to create content, I've been doing it for the past 3 years, could help you. And so when I network with people, I talk to them about creating content. I make no money when I teach someone how to create content, no money. But they look at my content, they're like, what the hell is Velocity Bank? What the heck is that? Oh, you want to learn? Boom, I got a course right here. You can consult with me on this, da, 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 right? So that 10X route is so powerful. I wish more Christians would do it. I wish there was like a Christian way to present this, because the source, Grant Cardone, of the 10X rule, which is taken from the Bible at the end of the day. I mean, you can track it. You look at certain scriptures where 10X, tenfold, right? I hope I'm not alone here, but you go back into script, you'll find that number, how interesting it's used. But nonetheless, in this world, 10X comes from Grant Cardone. I think he even trademarked the thing, if I'm not mistaken, but fully branded. But this is not necessarily a Christian. It's not a Christian dude. So you got to take it with a grain of salt, some of the things he says, and see how can I apply it in a kingdom-like manner. I think that's where most Christians get disconnected, because they see what the rich are doing, but they don't know how to take that message and convert it back to its originator, because that's what it is. I mean, the sinner or the non-believer or the in-betweener or whatever is taking principles from the originator, the Bible, from the creator itself, and they're maximizing it more than the avid Christian reader of the Bible. It stuns me every time. It's like, wow, wish there was a way to present this to the church. And I'm working on that, but we'll see. But this route is very interesting, because it may not cost as much as we think. And it didn't cost me a whole lot, but it's that fear. I think that's the real cost, right? That fear. Exactly. That is a big cost. I won't lie. That's a big cost. But I'm saying monetary cost to 10X, you'd be surprised.